Now we have all these values. We start by drawing horizontal and vertical axis, and we draw the voltage on the vertical axis. Now we need to decide current scale. Here I am taking 1 centimeter as 4 amperes. So if no load current is 9 ampere, then the length will be equal to 9 divided by 4, which is 2.25 centimeter. Practically, we need to take current scale such that the circle which we draw will be such that it has diameter more than 25 centimeter, so that we can read the performance data with reasonable accuracy. So now we need to draw I0 as vector OO dash from the origin of length 2.25 centimeter, which lags the voltage by 78.5 degrees. So we measure 78.5 degrees from the vertical axis with the voltage and draw OO dash, okay, of length 2.25 centimeter. Next, we need to draw the normal short circuit current 101.3 ampere. So that we give name OA vector of length. Again, we need to divide by the current scale. So 101.3 divided by 4. So this will be equal to 25.325 centimeter, lagging at angle 66 degree behind the voltage. Okay, this is this point we name it as A. Okay, the point of the OA vector we name it A. Now, next we need to draw a line joining O dash and A. We join O dash and A. Now we draw a horizontal line O dash D from O dash parallel to the horizontal axis OX. Okay. Now next we need to draw the perpendicular bisector of the line O dash A, the green line. Okay. So for that we take a fixed length in compass or what we call divider or arcer and draw arc on both sides of O dash A, the green line, from both the sides. First from O dash, we take some fixed length and draw arc, then we take the arcer for the same length and draw the arc on the downside of the green line. Now we keep the same length and make the arcs from the A side on both sides of OA, such that these arcs will intersect each other. The arc from A must intersect the arc from O dash. Same thing we do on the side below. Now the line joining these two arc crossing is the perpendicular bisector of the line O dash A. So we draw perpendicular bisector NC of the line O dash A from the points we get from the arc. Now where this perpendicular bisector intersects the blue line O dash B is given the name C. That will become the center of the circle. Okay. Now how to draw the circle? We take C as the center and draw a semicircle of radius equal to O dash C. Now here the length of O dash C is 12.81 centimeter. So the circle diameter will be 25.62 centimeter. So we take the arcer and draw a circle from center C. This semicircle is the locus of current vector for all load conditions from no load to short circuit for the induction motor. Now we need to take care that the circle must pass through point A. If the circle which we draw by this method is not passing through point A here, then that means we have done some mistake in measuring or taking the arcs, or there is some mistake in drawing. Now we need to draw a vertical line from A to the horizontal axis. We mark point F at the point where it intersects O dash D and mark G at the point where line intersects the horizontal axis OX. Now it is given that rotor copper loss is equal to half the total copper loss. So we need to divide AF in two equal parts and mark the midpoint as E. And we need to draw a line from O dash to the midpoint of the line AF, which is E. O dash E is called the torque line, and it separates stator copper losses and rotor copper losses, which are I square R heat losses. And O dash A, the green line, is called the output line. Now, voltage here is drawn on vertical axis, so all the vertical lines or distances represent the active or power or energy component of current, which is in phase with voltage. Now, AG here, the entire red line represents the PSN, the short circuit power at normal voltages, which is equal to 28440 watt. So, the length of the AG is 10.34 centimeter. So, we need to now make it as power scale. So, 1 centimeter will be equal to how many watts of power? That would be our power scale. So, for that we divide the total power by the length of AG. So, 28440 divided by 10.34 will give us 2750.48 watts. So, this is our power scale for this diagram. Now, all the vertical distances will give us the value of power. 1 centimeter will give us 2750.48 watt. This is our power scale. Now, vertical distance from O dash to the horizontal axis, this vertical distance here represents the no load input, which supplies the core losses and friction and windage losses, and a very small amount of stator losses which we neglect during the no load operation. So, this point here, FG, represents the same fixed losses of motor at the full short circuit operating point. Now, the torque line divides rotor and stator copper losses. So, AE represents rotor copper losses and EF represents stator copper losses. This is our complete circle diagram. So, this is how we draw the circle diagram for induction motor from the no load test and short circuit test data. Now, we calculate different values from this circle diagram. The method how to read different operating parameters like full load current, slip, power, etc. are in the next video.